So with that, we realize he's not the great exception, he's the great example. So if he's the great example, the story of Jesus has to be the great example of something greater. The story of the three wise men, the epiphany that we celebrate today, that wonderful experience must be something greater than just reading it literally, greater and have deeper meaning than just three men with or without fire helmets appearing there at the birth of the child of Jesus. So we find here, we look through the wonderful symbolism of Scripture. We look for the deeper meaning in the metaphors and the symbols that are presented to us in each story. For we find the wise men really symbolize that stored up resources of the soul which rise to the surface when stirred, that hungering and thirsting for wisdom, that hungering and thirsting for the enlightenment experience. That when there is this light that shines, this light off in the eastern area, and the east always represented something great and spiritual. So it is when that star is shining, that light is illuminating within our lives, it inquires, it stirs us, it makes us inquire and say, we want to go and see, we want to experience more. That inner knowing within us becomes that wise man that says, I want to know, I want to experience. Let us go and see. Let us go and follow the light of that's shining, that's unfolding wisdom for our lives. Suddenly, this story now is unfolding of our spiritual journey. It's not just a historic moment. It's not just something we read in the Bible to be read literally, but it's telling us of our individual journey, that we too have a hunger and thirst for more of God. We want to know more. So we follow the illuminating sources, the light. Scripture says the word is a light unto our path, right? We look to these wonderful spiritual texts that are lights unto our pathway that excite us and incite us to have more and more desire to learn, to know and experience more. We want to go and discover the Christ within our own lives. So too, the baby Jesus symbolizes that Christ consciousness born within each and every one of us. So as wise men and women, we come in the search for unfolding of the wisdom deep within our lives. We come and we desire to have this epiphany, this wonderful moment where we come to discover the Christ conscious within us. Now we know Christ is a term. It is not a last name. It's not Jesus the Christ, meaning that is his name, but is a term of the anointing, of the enlightened one, of that which is really experiencing the full consciousness and awareness of God within. That's the beauty. So when we're looking for the Christ, what are we looking for? We're looking for an awakening, a Christ moment, a consciousness that unfolds within us. A spirituality that is unfolding in a dynamic way. So we come to this moment. We come as wise men and women. We come following a light that's guiding us to this wonderful greater awareness within our hearts and our lives. Now, as we come to the baby, we come to arrive at the home, shall we say, as the story unfolds. It's the story of our life. Well, what do we bring to the baby? What do we bring as our gifts? Most recently, Stephanie had a baby shower. Big question Robert and I had is, what do we bring? What do we bring for the baby shower? You know, we thought, well, we went online. She had all these things, and we don't know. We've been so far removed from those days of holding a little baby within our arms. Those were, you know, 36 years ago for me. I'm now into grandkids and well beyond that. So, you know, what does the family need? Well, there's diapers. Well, probably she's going to have a lot of diapers. Well, there's onesies. But she's going to grow out. They're going to grow out of onesies. You know, well, is there this or that, this toy or that? What will they appreciate? You know, it's frustrating. What do you bring? So it is, as we come to this experience of this Christmas season, we're coming to the awareness of a Christ within us. Like wise people, what are we going to bring? Now, if you were gay, you'd bring a casserole, of course. To any event, a casserole is always important. Now, you know, if you're a lesbian, you might think, well, tools would be good. You know, how about that? You know, we might look at that. You know, we could go on to the list, you know. You know, we could go on through the list as young mothers would say, we need this, we need that. We know. I'm going to suggest three great things that you might bring to your personal experience of a Christ consciousness born within you. Three wonderful gifts. They're crucial. They're very important. And I invite you to bring them to this new year of 2019, that these gifts that you bring are going to be transformational and set the course for your entire journey of this year as well as the years ahead. Understanding that as we come to this moment of the Christ awareness within us, of a consciousness of God within us, we bring gifts with us. And here's your gift list. First, the first gift, wrapped, of course, has to be wrapped. There you go. Gift wrapped. The first gift you would bring is the gift of faith. How important that is that we think about this, because when we bring this, it's a gift that is really an understanding of our spiritual journey that is all about our faith life. God is this great intelligence that we call this universal mind. Everybody get that? That's sometimes thrown out there a lot, and we kind of like, wait a minute. God is this great intelligence. Now, we talk a lot about God. God is not God's name. God is what God does, right? God is not the name of God. What God does, what God is this infinite universal intelligence that's found everywhere and in everything. It's all around us. That universal intelligence we might call universal mind. Full. That mind that is full of all the wisdom of the ages. Do we not say that God is all-knowing, right? And knows everything? Do the ancient texts not tell us that God knows the desires of your heart even before you ask? That's the infinite knowledge. That's the universal mind or the infinite intelligence of the divine that's there. So when we call it a universal mind, we're saying this is the wonderful wisdom of God that is found within everything and every moment and in everyone. How many remember the phrase we say? There's not a spot where God is not. That's a great phrase for us to hold within our hearts and our lives every single day. There's not a spot where God is not. There's not a moment where God is not. There's not an event where God is not. There's not a thing that God is not dwelling within. You see, the power of that infinite knowledge and intelligence, that wisdom of the ages, is within all things and within you and you and you. So that universal mind is within us. That infinite knowledge is within us because what? We're created in the likeness and image of God, right? You're created in that likeness that says that there is an infinite wisdom within you. Ooh, wait a minute. Some of you say, I don't know if there's infinite wisdom within me. Because there's a couple times when I'm thinking, I'm not all that smart and all that brilliant. But it's that unfolding, like a wise man, seeing the light that draws you, say, I'm going to follow it. I'm going to seek it. I'm going to follow this, that the unfolding of wisdom of a greater Christ consciousness, of a greater understanding of spiritual truth, happens within our own lives. This Christmas epiphany is really the story of our spiritual growth. And I love how it begins the new year. This is your year for immense spiritual growth. We can look back at the last year. We may think, how have I grown? How have I matured? How have I changed? What did I learn? What experiences did I have? What came to me? You know, we just sang the Lord's Prayer, and there's a beautiful phrase within the Lord's Prayer that says, give us this day our daily bread. Now, we're not asking for a loaf of bread. We're not praying in that prayer, you know, give me some good whole wheat, Wonder Bread, I don't know, something with sesame seeds on top, a little sliced bread, maybe not sliced bread, whatever. That's not what we're talking about at all. That passage is saying, give us this day our daily bread. What did bread symbolize? But that which nurtures the soul, which feeds the soul. Give us this day our daily understanding of truth, our daily revelation. Now, sometimes revelations come in challenging forms, don't they? We learn sometimes the best at the school of hard knocks. Some of us, that's the only education we ever get. We got to learn the hard way. I've got a son who's 36 years old. He's great at the school of hard knocks. He has a doctorate degree in that one. He's learned by the experiences of saying, no, I'm going to learn it by myself. Dad, I know you told me. Dad, I know you instructed me. Dad, I know you guided me, but I got to learn for myself the hard way. Give us this day our daily bread is that prayer. Give us this day our daily revelation, our daily understanding of truth. Give us this day the light that I, as a wise person, may follow it, that it may unfold greater understanding for my spiritual life this year. So looking at last year, what did you learn? What did you receive? How did you grow? How did you change? How are you different? Because if you're not growing, changing, what is your spiritual life all about? Because it is about that development. It is about that transitions, that evolution that's going on within your life. So here's this beautiful journey for us, that our first gift is that we bring this wonderful understanding of faith, which is the law of mind and action. That sounds kind of technical, sounds kind of heavy. Let's break that down. The law, meaning it's a promise. It's going to work. So when we enter this, that very principle, it says, as you believe, so shall you receive. That's the law. The law of mind in action. Mind, that universal mind. The mind of God. When I begin to think, the mind of God. That which I believe, that which I will receive. That's a law. Now, you can trust the law. You can trust these wonderful promises. Because we know that they're always going to be true, right? If it's a law, it's a law. The law of gravity, how many of you ever said the law of gravity does not work? I'm telling you, the law of gravity is working on me all the time. I know it's working. It's all around me. It's holding me down, pulling me down. I'm working against it. I'm trying hard to work against that law of gravity. It's there. It's a promise. It's there. It's a principle. It's at work. So it is the spiritual law that says, as you believe, so shall you receive. It's the law. We can trust in that. We can build our life on that. We can walk in great assurance on that. We can build this year of 2019 on this very law at work within our lives. It says, I'm believing and I'm receiving. And as I believe, I receive. But it's as I believe. I got to believe first. If I'm not believing, am I receiving? No, it says, as you believe. In the process of your unfolding of your belief, that's how you're receiving amazing things within your life. Because it's usually this wonderful statement that sums it all up for us is, thoughts held in mind produce after their kind. Say it with me. Thoughts held in mind produce after their kind. Thoughts held in mind produce after their kind. A great one that you could slogan, you could write above your refrigerator, put it on your mirror, put it on your dashboard, put it somewhere in your life where you'll see it every day to say, I know that this is simply saying to me, as I believe, I'm going to receive. If I hold this thought in mind, it will reproduce because I'm believing it. Now, here's the big thing is, how do we hold this in mind? How do we hold it? Well, first of all, if I give this to you, you're going to say, what? I don't see anything. What am I holding? What do I do with this? You see, to hold something, you have to receive it. You have to say, oh, I get it. I'm holding it. I see it. I get it within my heart and life. I'm holding this to be here. And when we hold it, we want to hold it with such great firm hand on it that it's not like, oh, hot potato. I got to get rid of this thing. I don't even know what to do with it. You know, it's too hot to hold. No, it's our belief. I hold it in mind. I hold it there in my consciousness, in my thought process. This I believe. And I hold onto it securely. I don't let it slip out of my fingers. I don't let it run away out of my consciousness. But I hold on with this depth of security to it. I possess it. This is how important that we understand that we hold it in mind, holding in consciousness. As you believe, that's how you hold it. You're believing it there. So that which we hold in mind will produce after its own kind. And that's why the scriptures have always talked about us of having faith that's not wavering, not fluctuating, not going like a hot potato, throwing it up and down. I believe, I don't believe, I believe, I believe, I don't believe. I'm sometimes with it, I'm sometimes not with it. Yeah, it's not like that at all. It's a consistency. I hold it in mind. This is why Jesus told us when we pray, we should believe we already have what we desire. I believe that when Jesus took those loaves and fishes in his hand, he already had held in mind that 5,000 would be fed. I believe he already held it in mind. I don't believe he held that fish up and those loaves before all those hungry lives and said, I hope this works. I'm not sure. I'm going to try this. I'm going to try, but don't try it at home because, you know, I ain't going to work for you. He didn't say anything. I believe he already had it in mind, because with such confidence, he said, bring this little basket to me. And the young boy gave it to him. And he took the bread and he broke it, having blessed it and prayed with such a confidence. It says, I hold in mind that it will reproduce after its own kind, after kind and kind. How beautiful this is to understand that Jesus demonstrated this for us. Now, when you're holding it in mind, rest with it. Don't wrestle with it. Because holding something in mind, holding it in consciousness, is not to wrestle with it, not to disturb it. You know, Stephanie's got this newborn baby. And I'm going to venture to say she holds that baby with a firm hold, a confidence that allows that baby to rest. I'm thinking others would probably caution her about, you know, don't toss the baby around, don't fuss with the baby, don't wrestle with the baby, all those kind of stuff. This newborn, this infant needs to be caressed and held tightly. So it is, we rest in that. And when Jesus said, it is done unto you as you believe, he implied that there is a power that can, will, and must react to us. That's the promise. As you believe, so you receive. So the power of God will react. It will respond to that which you are believing within you. This is the spiritual law that as a man thinks, so he is. Echoed again over in Scripture. The power of this acts as a law operating on our beliefs. It says, I am guaranteeing this to you 100%. If you believe, you hold in mind, hold in consciousness, you shall receive. For as you think, so it will be, so you are, so it unfolds for you. Quite often we limit our thinking and we begin to think with a faith that is small and, you know, think, oh, you know, let me just think in small ways. So I'm asking you, if you're going to the river of blessing and I'm taking you there and I'm telling you that there is an infinite stream that's flowing, a wide river, a Mississippi, let's visualize, that is huge, and it's full of infinite blessings for you. What are you bringing as a container? Are you bringing a thimble? Or are you bringing a 50-gallon drum? Which is it? Now, if we know that there's infinite blessings for us, there's a Mississippi River of God's divine blessing flowing in this world around us, what are you coming to with your faith? And how large is your faith? Is it the size of the thimble, or is it the 50-gallon drum? Because that's what it will be. For as you believe, and to the level of which you believe, is what you're going to receive. You're thinking small, receive small. You're thinking big, think big. How important this is. For we can change our thinking, and in doing so, we cause the law of mind to act affirmatively instead of negatively. So maybe you've been thinking, oh, God's not going to, this is too hard for God. This is too difficult. This is a hard task. You know, this is a really big prayer request. Oh, it's a really big one. I talked to a minister on Facebook this past week, and he was saying, oh, I need prayer, and this is a biggie. This is a real big one. And he says, I'm putting out there, please, God, please, please. And everybody say, please, God, you know, on Facebook, come on, come on. And people are posting, please, God, come on, God, you can do it, God, come on, God, we're playing, we're praying, we're, you know, wait a minute. You see how it is? The very law of God will be at work as you believe. When you're certain, please, when you're begging, you're saying, I'm not sure. I'm not really confident. I'm not really there 100% on board with this. So I need to say, please, would you do it? Because I don't have the faith. I don't have the power and the belief. But remember, all the miraculous unfolds as you believe. Not as Jesus believes, but as you believe. So many times we're turning to Jesus. Jesus, you do it for me. Jesus, you do it. You believe for me. Jesus, you do the miracle for me. Jesus says, no, I'm asking you. You believe. And as you believe, so it shall be within your heart and your life. So what happens is the sum total of our thinking decides really what happens to us. That's true. For this new year, your thinking, how you think about it, how you're going to approach it, it's going to be the sum total of how your new year unfolds for you. So is your faith saying, this is a great year, a dynamic year, full of prosperity, full of blessing? Denise has been here 1 year and her business has already doubled. How about we believe with her that says her business is tripling? And how about it's expanding well beyond that? So it's according to our belief, because her whole year and experience here at City of Light will be based on the thoughts she brings. Now, we've had other collaborative partners here who say, you know what, I was here and I got an office, but I didn't have any clients and things were struggling and I'm going to have to move out and give up. Well, where's our prosperity consciousness? Where's the power of our believing? Because the sum total of your thoughts, the total of your thoughts is going to decide truly your destiny as to what's happening within your life. For the Spirit of God responds to the script that you're writing. That's right. You're writing the script every day. Your faith, the words that you're expressing, are describing exactly what you'd like to see unfold. You're saying, I want a job. Okay? No, how about, let's cross it out. I have a job, because that's how I'm going to live. Tiffany is headed out to Kansas. We're praying for her. She's going for a job interview. We're believing right now she has a job. We're speaking it now with great faith. We're claiming that with her. There's an affirmative spirit that we say, not a questioning, not a wondering. Oh, please give her a job. Oh, God, let it be so. In your great mercy, would you please? No, it's no, God. We walk in this believing, knowing, affirming. Hallelujah. Tiffany's got a job. And she's going to go with that kind of attitude, believing that the job is already unfolding for her. This is the gift of faith you bring. Now, the next gift, wrapped, of course, is the gift of conviction. Having this great conviction. And how do we build conviction within our lives? Conviction saying, this I know. Well, how do you build anything? Practice, practice, practice. How important that is. My mother wanted me to be a great pianist. So at the early age, she locked me, confined me in a room with a piano. She said, here you go. You are going to practice, practice, practice. And so I began to look at those notes that the teachers, the music instructors would put set before me in that music. Here we go, up a row to a birthday party. That was the very first song I learned. Still remember that one. I have practiced that over and over again. I got so that I was so good at, here we go, up a row to a birthday party, that I felt like a concerto artist. I was Mozart in the moment. I was truly there as a keyboard proficiato. There I was just sensing I had practiced this and practiced this and practiced it. So too, you want to have a strong conviction in your life? And this is a big gift you need to bring to the Christ consciousness. You need to bring a conviction that says, I believe. I believe and there's no doubt. I believe and there's no doubt in me. And I want you to do this next year. Walk around your house talking to yourself. That's okay. I'll give you permission. No one will think you're crazy. You just keep walking around your house and say, I believe there is no doubt in my life. I believe there is no doubt in my life. I believe there is no doubt in our life. Because what we're doing is imparting, laying down the foundation of our consciousness that says, I have great faith and I believe, I trust. You know, as a small child, some of your subconscious thoughts that you think now, subconsciously, without even knowing and realizing, have been laid down and taught to you. They were ingrained in you. How many of you walk without thinking, or how many of you have to think before you walk? A lot of us are still walking without thinking, thank God. We can walk and just move because we don't have to think. Lift foot, put foot down, lift other foot, lift it up, put down. You know, we just walk. Why? Because we've laid it down in our subconscious. And so we move and respond. We do things without even taking a moment to think about them. They respond from our subconscious. So it is, the more we lay down in our subconscious, the more it will be natural when something comes to us. We're not going to respond, crisis, crisis, oh, drama, oh, I'm afraid, I'm scared, I'm terrified, this will never work out. No, no. We've laid down a foundation, a conviction, because we practice, practice, practice over and over again saying, I believe. I believe, and I reject all doubts. I deny them. There's a power greater than I, and I realize I can use this power. God is at work within me, and the power of my faith, the power of my believing is at work right now, and that which I'm trusting God for is unfolding right now. I have this conviction that is very strong. 90% of our thinking is unconscious. Think about that. It's just an unconscious thought. 90% of what's going on in your mind and what happens through you, you're not really aware of it. So we should daily affirm that there is nothing in us that denies the good we affirm. We have to set down this pattern within our life. there was a woman, she loved to sew. She got a pattern. You know, one of those beautiful simplicity patterns. How many of you sew? How many of you have seen those kind of patterns? You get a little packet. My sister used to have those little packets. You pull it on. There was all the patterns. She laid out on the fabric, and she made her first dress, and she was like, oh, wow, I love this. I'm going to make me lots of dresses. She got different fabrics, different colors. She laid out that pattern, and after a while, she kept saying, why does every dress look the same? I changed the color. Last one was red. This one's blue. Why does every dress look the same? I changed the fabric. Last one was, you know, silk, and this one is polyester. I can't figure it out. Every dress looks the same. Well, honey, you got to change the pattern if you want a different dress. So it is within our lives that we've got to change the pattern of our thinking if you want a different outcome. You can't keep putting down the same pattern and expect a different outcome. Your pattern is, crisis comes and I panic. Crisis comes and I worry. Crisis comes and I'm stressed. Crisis comes, every time a bill comes to me, I fret and I just stress out and I get the hives and I get all kinds of worries and stress. I get an ulcer within me. Well, you know what? I hate to tell you this, but every time a bill comes, that's going to be your experience because that's the pattern that you're working off of. Change your pattern. Let's get a new one. Let's get a new simplicity pattern. And that simplicity pattern is simply confirming within our hearts and lives a strong conviction. I believe. So for this new year, I want you to bring the gift of great conviction. As you come to that Christ consciousness, you've come to that newborn babe experience within your life of God anew within you, bring this gift of conviction. The last gift, wrapped of course, is the gift of acceptance. Believe that we possess the good and that we desire, even though we don't even see that it's there. Because the hardest thing for us to do is to do something even when we don't see it. Now, we moved into this building. It's going to be soon. This year will be our third year in October. A 36,000 square foot facility. And on day one, we had all the expenses, but not one collaborative partner. It was just us. Wow. Day one, we moved in. We didn't have a collaborative partners. And you know what? We didn't advertise. We didn't run ads saying, come, have an office here, have a ministry here. You know what? We allowed the Spirit to draw to us everyone who has a ministry associated with us at City of Light here. It happens to us because we just accepted it as our knowing, and they came. We had an acceptance that says, well, we know it's going to be full. And people looked at us, how do you know it's going to be full? Did you run an ad? Did you ask people? Did you get on the phone? Did you call people? Did you invite people to come? What did you do? We walked in full acceptance. Now, we even looked at, should we have a property management company? We looked to inquire with a property management company and said, well, would you bring all the people in for us? And they said, oh, we would be delighted to be your property management company for you. We'll take X amount of money and X amount of funds from you and X amount of this and X amount of that. What would be left? And the Spirit of God says, allow me to be your property manager. Just accept. And one by one, people came, knocked on doors. Do you have an office? Could we join in a ministry with you? Could we collaborate with you? You know, we only have 4 rooms left, and we're going to be 100% capacity. We didn't advertise once. We walked in acceptance. Faith with conviction. And the acceptance of the answer being yours is one of these great gifts. And you have to say, all you have to do is say, I accept this response to my prayer. I accept the answer. I accept about it because part of the problem is we don't know how to receive the answer. We're still struggling with, I prayed, but I want to know how this is going to work out. How many of you go to the mechanic and have the mechanic work on your car, and you already know everything about the mechanic and how the car works, and you know everything about what they're going to do on your engine? You know exactly. Well, if you knew, you'd do it yourself, wouldn't you? But you don't know how. So you took it to a mechanic to do it, and your job was to trust the mechanic to fix the engine in your car. It's not your business to be a mechanic. You're not trained to be a mechanic. You're there to simply trust the mechanic to do it, to fix it. How many of you know how your computer works 100%? Well, we don't. You know, a lot of us said, I know the on and off button, and that's about it. You know, I know a few more things, yet we turn it on, and it's not our business to figure out how it works. Our business is to trust it works, and we do. How many of you know how electricity works? How many of you stand at the light switch and say, I need to know how this works before I flip this switch? If I don't know how this works, I am not doing it. I got to know how. Honey, a lot of us would be sitting in the dark. But what do? We realize the how electricity works is not our business. And so what do? We flip the switch. We turn it on. And we trust. You see, that's the whole journey of our life, is this, I do accept the good. Say it with me. I do accept the good. I believe my prayer is answered. Say it with me. I believe my prayer is answered. I do accept it now. Say it. I do accept it now. Because acceptance is an act of your mind. It's an act of your mind. You've got to set your mind in that direction. I have accepted it. Because there's a lot of us who say, I have believed, Pastor. I have prayed. I have a conviction. But not so sure I'm going to accept unless I know the how. This is how this is going to be. But we accepted our blind faith, saying, I don't know. I don't see it all. But I know that the promise, the law, the universal mind is at work right now. And I know that as I think with the mind of Christ, as I think, as I live and move with this kind of thinking and consciousness, something amazing happens within my life, and I accept it. So today, I'm inviting you to come to a baby shower. That's the newborn baby of Christ's consciousness within your life. And bring some gifts. Don't stress. I've already given you a gift list. It's easy as this. Let's bring some faith into 2019. Let's bring a strong conviction into 2019. Let's walk in a great acceptance into 2019. Because we're coming to this wonderful birthing of a newborn babe within us, of Christ awareness, consciousness, a mind that says, I know that I know that I know the God is there, that all-knowing, ever-present, never leaving nor forsaking, the love is with me. And I can now bring to this birth, to this moment, these wonderful gifts. Are you ready? Get set. Then let's go. What did today's text say? Go as you believe, so shall you receive. Go, move, now, ready, set, go. Here we go. Take these three gifts with us and let's move into a dynamic world. Let's move into a dynamic new year. Let's move into the realm of all kinds of possibilities as we exercise, as we practice, as we do what we're called to do, as we begin to live out this good news message that has been presented to us in the ancient texts down through the ages. Are you ready? Get set. Let's go. Amen.